The rock shelter of Bikram Khol is situated at a distance of about 12 kilometers from the industrial town of Belpahar in the reserve forest of the Lakhanpur of Belpahar Forest Range in Jharsuguda district. Situated on the summit of the hill, the rock shelter measures 33.65 meters, 5 meters, 6.50 meters in its length, depth and height respectively. The rock shelter faces to the east and northeast, oriented north-south. The shelter has a concave curvature with a seasonal stream flowing below. The stream joins the Ghugar, which is the tributary of the river Ib of the Mahanadi system. The shelter preserves the prehistoric engraving and painting on its back wall in an area of 11 meters in its length and 2.11 meters in its width. Two rows of scripts as well as some pictures of wild animals have been engraved on the wall of the cave within a 10-meter dimension which can be anticipated. 42 letters are written in two lines in the Bikram Khol cave. 23 letters out of 42 letters have been identified. That matches with Mohenjo-daro and Brahmi script. Some scripts have written multiple times. In this area, an advanced civilized human society was living in 5th century BC. It is assumed that they were using this script. The use of Anusar can be seen in the required field. There is no animal picture in the writing. It seems that at that time the advanced writing method was developed. Engraved pictures used as a symbol in writing. Some letters have jointed so that combined letter Sanjukta Varna is used. Some symbolic symbol have been used below and above script that show that they were knowledge of mantra or phala. Indian script is not developed from Semitic script, but Indian script is a form of evolution of the ancient cave script found in research. On the floor of the cave, 4 inches dimension and 2 inches deep, some holes were dug. Ancient tribal had been buttering their rice in these holes. Several holes have been made in the wall of the cave. The cave dwellers used to hang their clothes, foodstuffs and weapon by putting wooden stick in these holes. For a long time, the script and picture of Bikram Khol cave had not come in contact with people. The Bikram Khol cave came in contact with historians and researchers after falling into sight of some cowboy who grazed their cattle in a forest in 1924. A famous Indian historian, late Kashiprasad Jaiswal, had visited the cave in 1933. He opined that the engraving of Bikram Khol was a pictographic inscription, partially incised and partially painted in two lines. He further said that the writing was from right to left and the character of Bikram Khol inscriptions belong to a period intermediary between the script of Mohenjo-daro and Brahmi. Some letters are still retaining their original or proto-Brahmi form. This proves the origin of Brahmi to be an Indian and throws a plot of light on the history of writing as from Brahmi the Phoenician and European script are derived. Later on, scholars like N.P. Chakrabarty and Charles Fabry supported the theory put forth by Jaiswal that Bikram Khol engraving have the silent feature of an early writing. However, D.H. Gordon raised the objection and commented the left-hand portion of this masses engraving is by far the clearest. But even here, it is difficult to believe that what we see is writing. Although a certain number of signs have somewhat alphabetical form in appearance, however, a close scrutiny of the rock shelter reveals that what we see at Bikram Khol is nothing but paintings and 68 engraving of deer strangled with or without a depression at the center resembling female genital rhomboid pattern, honeycomb pattern, dot, cupules, cobra hood mark, palm, foot, etc., which, however, does not suggest of any kind of alphabetic form. Since the major portion of the engraving has already been eroded and obliterated by the rain water streaming on the encrypted rock surface from the top, it is difficult to identify or describe the surviving incision, which look more like a host of stroke dashes, a Rome and Brahmi alphabetic forms. A close examination of the engraving revealed that originally all these engravings, both figurative and non-figurative pattern and motifs, were pigmented with ochre, whose traces are still available in their U-shaped groups that measures 5 cm in width and 1.8 cm in depth on average. The occupational deposits on the floor yielded microliths of blades, flakes and core subjects of its antiquity to the Mesolithic period. It is a centrally protected site of the Archaeological Survey of India under Bhubaneswar Circle.